Hey guys, me and Ian again, and we are in Combloux, France, for another third trip of skiing. So every time we come down to the Geneva International Motor Show, we come up here and stay because it's actually cheaper than staying in Geneva. And of course we get to ski.
And it's beautiful.
And it's beautiful, of course. The snow's not as good as it was last year. It's been warm, so it's a bit drizzly right now. But I think as we get a little bit higher, you'll probably see some snow. Right now, the temperature's not too bad. I wouldn't say it's too cold, would you?
Yeah, it's probably about 6 degrees. A little bit of rain in the air, not quite snowing. It's on the on the cusp of snowing.
But. Yeah. So we'll try to ski up high where the snow conditions may be better. And it's already something like 3:30 in the afternoon, so we don't really have a lot of skiing to do today. So we'll warm up, get our ski legs back, and then maybe tomorrow head over to Megève. There's a real nice ski area over there, and being a bit higher in altitude, the snow might be better. But stay with us. We'll hope to bring you some interesting snowing and skiing video, and hopefully no falling.
Falling is inevitable.
It is for him. I don't want to fall. Here comes Ian down the slopes, first run. Look at that professional form. He's signing up for the South African Olympics next year in the intermediate class. So let's go catch him. Oh, first run. Weather's overcast. Last year, a bad day of skiing is better than a good day of work. So here we are. Let's get over there and get an interview with downhill champion Ian Pop. So Ian, is this your first time skiing?
No, this would be my third.
Oh, well.
A really, really good friend of mine taught me how to do this many years ago.
That's me.
Didn't teach me very well because I keep falling.
Well, you know, can't do everything. Now I'm going to take the high road. He'll take the low road. What are you doing over there? Last year when we were here, we were riding up on this lift and we were sitting in seat number 69.
Go figure.
And I was able to stick a Bad Monkey Touring decal up above. And now 69 is coming by right now. I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but it's right there next to 69. And it's still there to this day. That's brand marketing. Yeah, you can see Ian there coming down a blue run. He's the one in the middle that tends to go from one side to the other. I don't know if you can quite pick him up yet, but here he comes. There he is, he finally made it. So, we skied down a nice long blue, and now we had to come over and take one of these little, I forget what they call these things. You know, one you stick it up your butt and pulls you up, you have to ski uphill. T-bar, yeah, that's the word I was looking for. Anyway, almost to the top. Pick up another run down, see if we can maybe find a little mountainside cafe for something warm to drink.
do, I'll bring it to you in just a few minutes.
Well, girls, this is your dad going down a green run.
Bad monkey touring.
Usually referred to as a debutante run.
You see, he's not doing so bad. Look at that, like a champion. Let's go get a frontal shot, a side shot. Okay, here he is from the side.
Look at that. Whoa, got a steep hill.
Woo!
Look at that. Wow, watch out.
And here comes Ian.
Nicola's working, right?
In some parts of the world.
You're getting paid?
Bon appétit, monsieur.
Merci, monsieur. Caesar salad.
It's one of the best looking Caesar salads I've seen in a long time.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm just taking some tips. I always do like chicken strips, but it's quite nice like that when I've shaved it.
It's pretty good Caesar salad. It's got bell pepper in it though, which I'm not a fan of, but it's small, doesn't overpower.
So we just did. we just did this came down here. So we're over here. So we take this back to the top. Do this one. What was it? We did that one, and then that one. We didn't want to call some more yet. Anyway, to get here really is three reds. What is this long one here? What is this one? Yeah, but how do we get that? Anyway, just to do a blue across to there. No, we can go from here. I'm looking for roots at the top, but I think I'm going from the bottom.
So as the white rhino emerges from its woody layer, it comes out.
A really nice pair of red skis lying on the slope, so I stopped to pick them up.
Were they Rossignol?
Yeah.
Well, here's Ian on his first red run. He just lost it there, but now he's up running again.
I'm on the red!
Yes, he is. Well, it's our last day here in Combloux, France skiing. And once again, we're on the Beauregard lift going up from the base. But look at the weather. Heavy snow. It's been snowing this morning since about, I'd say 7, 8:30. It's so windy that they've closed all of the lifts except for this one and a couple of the lower T-bars. So we're just gonna, and they gave us a special price of 19 euro. For a half day, because we'll only ski till about 5 o'clock now. And would just stay on this lift and run the runs that come off of Beauregard, which aren't too bad. There's several. So we'll have a good time nonetheless. Don't you think?
I think we're going to freeze our asses off, but it's going to be fun.
Yeah, zero.
We ain't going to give up.
0 degrees. But it'll be interesting because it's fresh powder, and Ian is used to skiing on groomed slopes with, even if they're a bit choppy, but usually icy. So he's learned to, you know, turn and everything on that. And with this fresh snow, being that it's a bit thicker and drier, it's more difficult to turn. So we should have some interesting spills today.
Yep, I'm gonna try and give you guys a lot of really good falls, and hopefully we'll catch some on video.
Not me, I'm not gonna fall.
Bound to happen.
Not me. 2 days in so far, not a single fall. One more day to go. Stay with us. So here comes Ian, skiing on the nice new snow. There's nothing like the feel of skiing on new snow, and it's so quiet. The only thing you hear sometimes is the crunching of the packing of the snow. But this is fantastic. I love skiing on new snow. How do you like the new snow?
It's so different. You glide completely differently.
Yeah, and it's quiet.
Yeah, there's none of that scraping ice sound.
Right.
It's smooth.
Yeah, too much fun. I love it like this. Anyway, I'm gonna turn the camera off and ski a little bit. Let me do it like this. We're on top of the Beauregard lift again, and we just did a really nice blue run all the way to the bottom. And it was so peaceful and quiet through the trees that I wanted to bring it to you without any narration or anything. So here we go, we're gonna ski all the way down. It's 2.9 kilometers, all on the Beauregard run, and it's absolutely fantastic. So stay with us, and I hope you enjoy it. Here we go. bonus for us, as we after we stopped and had a little snack and a drink, apparently the wind has let up, the snow has let up a lot, and the sun's peeked through a little bit. But as we're skiing on down, we see some people off to the left on a different run that's only accessible by another lift. So we ended up basically just looking up, and I saw that the people on the lift were going up, and this lift was supposed to be closed, but now it's open, and we're heading on up to hit some of the upper mountain.
Half price, baby. Yeah. Half price.
Half price. Half price skiing is for me. Oh well, I hope that the passes you know, don't have specific lifts on them to where we get up there and then we realize we can't get back down. But I don't think they really have that technology. I think it's just they booked us half price because they thought that the lifts would not be open, but they are. So great, let's go hit them. Absolutely fantastic. Look at the snow. Here comes Ian. Wow, truly amazing skiing. The snow is so pristine. And it's so peaceful. Let me show you. Ian's having fun. Here's Ian coming down a steep red. He hasn't fallen yet. All right, here we go. Nice and steep, keep it straight. There's a lot of places you can choose to rent your ski equipment and snowboard equipment, or purchase if you like, when you come to Combloux. But my favorite is Sport 2000. It's right across the street from the hotel and right at the base of the lift. So you can't really beat it. The prices are good. You can almost always get a discount with a coupon from the hotel. This year we got 25% off. So for the 3 days we rented, it was only 69 euros. And they've got a great little shop, and I can see that everything's on sale, probably for closing out certain models and probably end of season. So have a look around here. So there you go, Sport 2000 in just across the street from the Alpine Valley Hotel. Come and see them, they're the best around.
Well folks, we've had a great 3 days worth of skiing. Today was the culmination of it all with the new snow, and the temperature was perfect, and got Ian on the red runs.
So didn't fall.
Yep.
Didn't fall.
Didn't fall. So now he is a accomplished skier. Yep. And we'll no longer be spending any time on the green runs. So we're here at a little restaurant just up the street from our hotel, and it's called Le Petit Coucher, and it's a hotel as well. We might give it a try next year because, as I said before, they're changing Alpine Valley into a four-star hotel, so it might drive the price up. And we'll see, but it looks like a great place to stay. It's right on the parking lot for your car here, and you can ski right in, right off of Beauregard Red Run, right out here. Really cool. But thanks for joining us. We really appreciate sharing everything with you. So until next time, thanks for joining us. Safe travels.
Cheers.
Cheers.